Now we'll have the presentation of Professor Nuno Ferran, the University of Porto, in the northern part of Portugal.
Thank you. So I'd like first to compliment Professor Luís Aires Barros and Professor Gunter Stock. I want to acknowledge this invitation, and it's with great honor and great pleasure that I'm here today. Also, I'd like to compliment all the LA members. Different from my my colleagues, what I want to say is my short story about the idea of creating a research center in my field, which is biology, evolutionary biology, or the understanding of why we are all different, why there are so many species in the world, and why are we losing all this diversity. This morning we heard about the Anthropocene, this morning we heard about climate change, and we heard about a very important problem, which is the erosion of biological diversity. We are losing biological diversity as never in the past. So that was the idea. Well, when we were in 2000 and the Lisbon agenda or strategy was being discussed here, I was a bit lost. I was actually totally lost because I barely had my PhD degree at that time. And I didn't fit in any of the research centers at that time at the University of Porto. And so I was thinking about what to do in life, and I thought, well, there was something in there that was interesting. We should do something by creating networks, both at the national and the international level. So I was looking around the country, around Portugal, and looking about colleagues that could share this interest in doing evolutionary biology, in this understanding biological diversity. And we could find some very good people in Porto, in Lisbon, in Évora, in the Azores. And so we started to think about to build this research center, about to build this research network. So we thought about, of course, having fun, doing great science, being able to pass this appreciation of the biological diversity of our world to all citizens, to all the public, but also being able to provide services to society and also being able to train people in the biological sciences. This is a unique opportunity because we are grounded in natural history, but we have the best age of biology today. We have genomics. We have the best genomic platforms. We can do genomes at a speed just like that, and by paying nothing today. We can sequence in a day from virus to full human genomes in our biological labs today. So we decided to merge these different people and start building this network that finally, in 2011, was given this concept of associate laboratory in Portugal, which means a key lab in a specific field. Actually, our research center, CBU in Bio, is the single key lab, associate lab in Portugal in the biological field. So from a very few people, we were able to build this network in the country. And today, from a very few friends in 2002, we are about 400 people located at universities of Porto, Coimbra, of Porto, Lisbon, Évora, and the Azores. Today, we have about 20 different research groups that goes from pure molecular biology, that goes from the understanding of the origin of species. What is speciation? How it is? What are the molecular mechanisms that drive the emergence of two forms starting from one? But we cross a lot of different areas, from remote sensing, from images from satellites, from computing science, from computational biology, from nanobiology, all together to and address our questions of interest. And we go up to our cities because we need to have more green cities. We need to green our cities. We need to have more green, more gardens. We need to have more biodiversity in our cities overcrowded with people. So this is the landscape of our research center today. We have collaborations all across the world today, and of course we have a very good scientific productivity. And last year, I'm very proud to say that we did a premiere in Portuguese science by doing a simultaneous release of a science paper together with a plant genetics paper with a major contribution of a highly talented student of mine in CBU at University of Porto. So both papers, by using a mammalian model to understand both speciation and domestication, were simultaneously released by those major journals. So you can see the number of and the impact of our work in this all along these years, and we are talking about a research center that is not more than 12 years old. And of course, and we heard about that a lot already today, we are doing a lot of transfer technology using all fields of biology, from the molecular, the most deep molecular methods, to the most advanced ecological eco-informatics methods to provide services to society. In fact, our structures doing this on a more molecular or in the more ecological side are, for example, employing about 30 people in my research center. And not only this offers employment to the people, as well as many of our revenues are reinvested for doing research. Then it is very important, of course, that if we do that, we should do a lot of public awareness. We should do a lot of outreach in order that people understand what we are doing. So we are actually, in collaboration with University of Porto, doing a total renewal of the museums of natural history and science at Porto. And so the idea is that we will rebuild everything by introducing a modern and innovative concept of museology to have people together with us. Natural history, science museums, art and science museums are the perfect places to have citizens with us. And our goal is to bring citizens into our museums and to participate in our research programs. Again, because outreach is so important, and because in CBU we have research projects all over the globe, so we are producing for one of the Portuguese main TV channels a series of documentaries for the first time in Portugal that will compete, for example, with the so well-known BBC wildlife programs, but with a different concept, where not only it is important that very great pictures and sceneries of wildlife will arrive at the homes of everybody interested in biology, but also why our researchers are doing that in Australia, in Mongolia, in South Africa, in Brazil, and in many, many, many places working in so with so many different species. Why? What is the curiosity behind this attitude? So this will be the first series of 13 episodes will come very soon in the Portuguese television. Then what is important also is the relation with the industry. I must say that it would be probably not very much expectable, but most of our budget comes from private funds. So for example, you can see their EDP, or the Portuguese railways, or the Portuguese distribution of energy. Well, they are sponsoring chairs at CBU. They are sponsoring chairs, invited chairs, at the University of Porto to investigate the impact they have in the ecosystem, in the landscape, and in the biological diversity. And so this connection between what we do and the real world is something that is absolutely priority in our research. Well, I think we will have very good opportunities for the next 6 years. 1 month ago, we just won an area share. We have been talking about the European research area, and one of the tools that we have in Portugal, that where we are extremely competitive, is this, the area share tools. We just won one to create a share, a position, at the University of Porto to do research in environmental metagenomics, in environmental DNA, or every use that we can do or apply by collecting minor amounts of DNA that is around in the environment. So this is a 2.5 million investment in CBU for the next 5 years. We have strong training programs, not only for Portuguese people, but for example, we have just we just got a grant to train the next generation of biologists in Angola. Angola was a former Portuguese colony in which biodiversity at some point was extremely important because of several reasons, because of an extended war. They lost many, many things, but they are now recovering. And we will have a major role by training this new generation of Angolan biologists. At the same time, and we talked a lot about infrastructures, we do have now a Portuguese national roadmap of 40 infrastructures that deserve all fields of science. I just mentioned LifeWatch, which is in Esfri, and Genome Portugal, which is a national network for studying the biology of genomes. Finally, I'd like to say that we are doing an internationalization strategy that is based on the creation of what we call twin labs. And by twin labs, I mean mixed teams between Portuguese and other country researchers. And in this case, we are privileging our relations with former Portuguese colonies or speaking countries in Portuguese. And so we established in the last few years twin labs in the Cape Verdes, in Guinea, Brazil, Angola, Mozambique. And with this extended network, we are doing a lot of capacity building in there, but also offering a variety of new opportunities for our students. And this is a strong component of our strategy and of our ideas for the next few years. We have exactly the same strategy for Northern African countries, and we have established twin labs in Morocco and Mauritania, and this is really important. We have heard in the last few days about the crisis in the Mediterranean. It's not only about doubling the number of boats in the Mediterranean, it's about doing or contributing for the development in that countries. And science is one of the best tools that we have to change really the social situation in the countries in North Africa. So this is our group that is based at University of Porto. You are all invited. It's not exactly in Porto, it's in a small town north of Porto called Vila do Conde, a very beautiful old town. And I'd like to finish just by paying my tribute to someone that was very important for all of us, José Maria Nogueira. He was an extraordinary person. He was a man of the Renaissance. He is indeed one of the persons that made things in a way that we are still here, that we still believe that it is possible to do great science and having fun in Portugal. And so I needed to say so. Thank you very much.
Thank you.